Once upon a time, not so very long ago,
last 10 years afraid to set foot outside your old apartment. You're gonna have a wonderful new life here. Wait till you see what a lovely bedroom we've made for you.
Oh, Meg. It's perfect. My favorite color. Pink.
My friend Gail's mother is dying to meet you. She loves to knit, too.
That'll be nice.
And Mrs. Bettini at the Y. She's looking for people for her folk dance group.
Good thing I packed my tambourine.
Ah, here we go, Grace. Just get these out and they should make you feel right at home.
You two have done enough already. I can certainly put out a few knickknacks by myself. Now go on.
"I've had such a curious dream," said Alice, and she told her sister as well as she could remember them all her strange adventures in Wonderland. Her sister kissed her and said, "It was indeed a curious dream, dear, but now it's time for tea." So Alice got up and ran off, thinking while she ran, as well she might, what a wonderful dream it had been. The end.
"Please, Mommy, read me another one."
"Oh, no, it's much too late." Oh, Meg!
Oh, those are some of my happiest memories.
Mine too. Meg! Mom? Your muffin is in the microwave. See you six-ish. Love, Meg. Darn things are dangerous anyway.
Really shouldn't have gone to so much trouble.
Since when is it trouble to make a meatloaf? Besides, you had almost everything I needed.
Oh, about half that, please, Mom. I'm watching my cholesterol.
Norm, a nice big slice for my growing son-in-law.
No, just about what you gave Meg would be fine. Thanks, Grace. Thanks. Perfect.
Norm, have some sweet potatoes. They're the way makes Dad like them, with a little bit of brandy.
Oh, Mom, tomorrow's Wednesday. The Silver Streakers.
The what?
The Senior Citizens Group. We talked about it.
Well, maybe.
Let me hold you, sweetheart. I'm in love with you. Let me hear you whisper that you love me too. Keep the love light glowing in your eyes so true. Let me call you, sweetheart.
Don't you like it?
Oh, yes, yes. It's just that I've never had kidney bean stroganoff before.
Our dietitian always says the cost of protein you can be use beans and cheese instead of meat.
Is he all right?
Mr. Magruder usually naps until the speaker. A doctor from Mount Sinai. His topic will be colostomies. A blessing in disguise.
And I thought I could work in the library or on field trips. I know how often a school needs an extra pair of hands, even these old ones.
Mrs. McQueen, it's awfully kind of you to offer like this, but we have a rule in our school. You have to have a child enrolled here to participate in school activities.
Mrs. McQueen, we appreciate your interest, but some of our children are severely handicapped. It takes a great deal of physical strength to handle them. I mean, could you help a 200-pound disabled teenager out of bed?
No, but I could feed him, or write letters for him, or just let him know somebody cares.
But if he has a seizure or falls, both of you could be seriously injured. I'm sorry, Mrs. McQueen. Things here would be just too strenuous for you.
Thank you so much for stopping by, Mrs. McQueen. If we have any need for someone with your particular qualifications, we'll be in touch.
Umbrella, sweetheart. It's supposed to rain today.
What's this? Babysitter available? Oh, Mom.
You've worked so hard your whole life. Why can't you just relax?
It's something to do, that's all.
Well, the Senior Citizens Club is something to do. Oh, come on, Mom. Give it another chance. Gail Levine says they're making a friendship quilt.
Julie Pollard.
Mommy, I got the part in the play. Shelley Farnsworth was so sure she'd get it, but they picked me.
That's wonderful, Alexandra. Now, what night is that?
The 21st.
The 21st of December?
Is something wrong? No, no, nothing's wrong.
Alex, I'm late for a meeting. I'll talk to you later.
Will you be home for dinner?
Sure, I will. Bye-bye, sweetie.
About these test scores.
Otis, we can't let such a good program idea be shot down by 25 first graders in Seattle. I'd really like to test it a little more.
Not a chance, Julie. Starlight Starbright is history.
We all like this concept, Otis. Whatever happened to trusting our instinct and standing behind it? Isn't that what we do around here?
Not with sandbox toys. You know how those people are, Julie. They'll hold in a sneeze till someone in research tells them when to let it go. Now, this is the third idea in a row to test badly. If we don't pull it out by January 1st, our biggest account is going to take a walk. All right, everybody. Thinking caps back on.
This is the sensuous witch. You're on.
Hi, Clarissa. I'm a Leo. My boyfriend's a Capricorn, and he hasn't been showing much interest in me lately. Is it me or the planets?
Oh, not to worry, little lioness. This week's bad vibes for the daddy goat in your life. He's just thwarted in his work sector, that's all. Things will get back to normal once Venus shifts out of the career house on the 10th. This is the sensuous witch. You're on.
Hello, it's Capricorn with the Sagittarius.
Battery cable company.
I really think you're great, and I want to know.
Software on parade. The Krishna chef. What on earth?
It's time for Boogie with Bob, America's only gay aerobic show that we know of. So let's get started. Feet, shoulder distance apart, knees slightly bent, hips under stomach, thin, shoulders down, arms relaxed. Breathe it up and down. Breathe it up. And down again, breathe it up. And down one more, reach it up. Up, up again, four, four, three, two, both arms, push it up. Up, up again, four, four, three, two, across the chest, push it out. Out, out again, four, four, three, two, across the chest, push it out.
Out. Hello? Alex? I'm sorry, but I won't be able to go to the ballet tonight.
Oh, Mom.
I'm sorry, sweetheart, but I've just had a deadline moved up. Look, I've called Mrs. Chin,
and she'll pick you up at 5:30. Tickets are in my jewelry box.
Sweetheart, you can tell me all about it. Fine. If you're up when I get home.
I understand.
And the point spread this week on the Colts game is a fat 14 points. But I got it straight from my cousin in Vegas. Only a chump would bet on the Colts.
Great sauce, Grace.
Must have taken you all day to make.
I take it the senior citizen's lunch was rained out.
Breadsticks, dear? Norm, where does that battery cable company come from? I have never seen such strange TV shows.
Meg, I believe your mother has discovered public access television.
Public cruises?
Well, it's called public access, but vanity TV is more like it. Anybody who wants to can have their own TV show.
Anybody?
Well, yeah, anybody can be a star. Anybody with an axe to grind or a story to tell. Even you, Grace.
Me? Oh, how would I do that?
Well, you just go down to their studios, get in front of a camera, and that's it.
Must be expensive.
I don't think so. $50-$60 is all.
So little?
Well, how else could people just walk in off the street and afford it?
Oh, Mom, did you ever call Mrs. Bettini at the Y?
Are you thinking of going on the air, Grace?
Oh, me? Oh, I have never heard anything so ridiculous.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm Grace McQueen. I reserved a studio for 2 o'clock.
Have a seat. Ivana and the bear is running over again.
Excuse me. Yeah. Is that man all right?
Oh, that's Harry Crystal, the host of Harry's Herb Garden. He's always like that after a taping.
Where's the 2 o'clock?
Hello. I'm Grace McQueen.
This way, we're running late. Right over there.
Is this all of it?
You need any props, you have to bring them yourself. You read the manual, didn't you?
Oh, yes.
Where's your blank tape? Okay, when I say go, you're on. I stop the tape after 28 minutes, so you have to be done by then. I don't start over for any reason. So you need retakes, you gotta buy another half hour. You got that?
Yes.
How long's your lead-in?
My what?
You don't know what a lead-in is. Never mind. You're on.
Oh. Thumbelina. By Hans Christian Andersen. Once there was a woman who wanted a child more than anything else in the world. At last, in loneliness and sorrow, she went to a witch and spoke of her desire. Oh, don't worry, the good kind. You know, like the pretty one in The Wizard of Oz. That's as easy as winking, said the witch. Take this seed and planted in a flower pot filled with good, rich earth. Water it carefully and guard it very well. He was their king. She could tell he was kind by the sound of his voice. She felt that at last she had come home. Then he took off his crown and placed it on Thumbelina's head. You are so lovely, he said. Won't you be my queen? The end.
That was great.
Was I on time?
Right on the button. While you were reading that, I had an idea. Now, does this book have any pictures in it?
Oh, sure. Beautiful ones. Well, except for this one. My little girl decided to repaint the cottage.
Can you leave this with me? I'd like to cut some shots of them into the tape. It'll liven things up.
Well, isn't that what the manual calls post-production? I can't afford anything extra.
Oh, no. Don't worry about that. I'll just do it when everyone goes home.
Why, aren't you sweet?
Oh, I'm also going to try to come up with some titles. Now, what was the show called again?
Oh, dear, I hadn't decided on a name.
Why not name it after yourself?
Me?
Sure. The Story Lady.
The Story Lady.
The Story Lady.
Thumbelina by Hans Christian Andersen. Once there was a woman who wanted a child more than anything in the world. At last, in loneliness and sorrow, she went to a witch and spoke of her desire. Oh, don't worry, the good kind. You know, like the pretty one in The Wizard of Oz?
A beautiful butterfly flew near her. Fascinated by its gossamer wings, Thumbelina sat very still to show she meant no harm. The butterfly kept dancing toward the sash on her dress, and Thumbelina thought to fasten one end loosely around it. She tied the other end to the stalk of a lily pad, and the butterfly flew along, pulling the lily pad behind him like a little toy boat.
Scott!
Hey there, story lady.
This is for you. You're much too thin.
What's this?
My world-famous sour cream coffee cake.
For me?
It's for making the show look so fancy. I thought I was watching real TV. Where did you learn to do those things?
Well, 4 years of film school helped. Yeah, look where it's got me.
Oh, someone as smart and talented as you will find something better soon. I'm sure of it.
Yeah, right. Now, look at your next surprise.
Well, where did all this come from?
Let's just say the producer of Riches Through Real Estate won't be needing them anymore.
Oh. Did he get that rich?
No, he got 10 years. What's this week's story?
The Little Mermaid.
Great. Just leave me the book when we're through so I can cut in the illustrations. All right. Ready when you are, SL. Grace, are you all right?
Oh, sure. I was just thinking I was always so afraid of ending up in a rocking chair when I got old.
Do you want another chair?
Oh, no. I like this one.
The story, lady.
Once there was a soldier, a steadfast tin soldier, one of 52 all made from the same tin spoon. And just like the other soldiers, he carried a rifle and swirled her rustling silk skirts in the air. She knew every eye was on her, and every man's heart was hers for the taking. The poor tin soldier ached whenever he saw her. How he longed to join her, to take her in his arms and whirl her over the polished floor until all the candles in the chandelier had flickered their last. But no. He had to stand there, stiffly, night after night, all alone. Sometimes...
Daddy, it's a quarter of four.
I know that, sweetheart.
You'll be late for work.
Just a little more, please!
Yo! Story lady!
Is something wrong?
Your fan mail's been piling up.
For me?
That's your name on him, isn't it?
Oh, wherever you are. To keep you on the right
trail.
Dear story lady, my daughter Shannon is too young to do it, so I'm writing to tell you how much she enjoys your show. In fact, I like it too, and try to watch with her when I can. It's nice to know somebody cares enough to put on such a good children's show. Keep up the good work. Sincerely, Barbara Witowski. P.S. Shannon sends the enclosed for you.
How come we never get letters like that? Huh?
You close the door. Join the dance.
Somebody in this house have homework tonight? Besides me?
After the story, lady. Come watch it with me.
Sorry, sweetie. I have hours of reading here. But go ahead and watch. It won't bother me.
Okay.
Today we're going to read The 12 Dancing Princesses, or The Shoes That Danced Themselves to Pieces. This was my daughter's favorite story when she was a little girl. I think
because she didn't take very good care of her shoes either. There was once upon a time a king who had 12 beautiful daughters. They all slept together in one chamber in which their beds stood side by side. And every night, when they were in them, the king locked the door and bolted it. But in the morning, when he unlocked the door, he saw that their shoes were worn out with dancing, and no one could find out how this had come to pass. So the king proclaimed that whosoever should discover where they danced at night should choose one of them for his wife and be king after his death. Thereupon, the king asked the brave soldier which of them he would have to wife. He answered, "I'm no longer young, Your Majesty, so give me the eldest." Then the wedding was celebrated on the selfsame day, and the kingdom was promised him after the king's death. The end.
Alex, do you watch this every week?
Mm-hmm. Heather Epstein loaned me The Steadfast Tin Soldier. Do you want to watch it?
Very much.
He looked at the little dancer, and she looked at him, and he felt that he was melting away in the fire. But he still managed to keep himself erect, shouldering his gun bravely. A door was suddenly opened. The draft caught the little dancer, and she fluttered like a sylph, straight into the fire, to the soldier, blazed up, and was gone. By this time, the soldier was reduced to a mere lump. And when the maid took away the ashes next morning, she found him in the shape of a small tin heart. All that was left of the dancer was her spangle, and that was burned as black as a coal. The end.
Ah. Well, ladies and gentlemen, if this woman wasn't born to entertain children, I'm in the wrong business.
She's telegenic, but awfully soft.
Soft is hot now. The whole industry skew is letting kids be childlike again. This is one angle nobody's touched on, a fantasy grandmother.
Hope it tests well.
It's already been researched. My daughter says half her class runs home to watch her.
And Otis, this old lady probably doesn't know the meaning of the word agent or royalties. We can lock her up for years for peanuts.
I had a hunch that might occur to you, Larry.
All right, Julie. You found us a property. Check her availability and work up a script.
Now, on the toy tie-ins, Eastern Europe has begun undercutting Asia by about 22%.
And I need this room done in early indestructible. Good luck.
Well, I don't think that'll be a problem. Now, this room has wonderful bones. For this room, I see...
Bring in a huge four-poster bed with 20 feather mattresses on top and 20 thick downy quilts on top of them.
No, Mom, not in the family room. Mom?
The Lord Chamberlain, who wasn't all that bright, said, "But Your Majesty, why?" And then the old queen said, "If she can feel the pee through all that, then truly she must be of royal blood."
The princess and the pee. Tell me, Grace, how long have you been the toast of public television?
Oh, not so long. A couple of months.
Why that? I mean, why not be a hospital volunteer? Something a little less peculiar.
I tried. For over a month, I traipsed all over creation, and everywhere I went, they said no. So I thought, well, if I can't be with the kids, at least the kids can be with me.
But you promised you wouldn't do anything tiring.
That was about babysitting. You never said a word about my having my own TV show.
Somehow, Mom, that didn't occur to me.
Meg, if it makes her happy, I don't see what the problem is. It sounds like kind of a good idea to me.
That program's a lot of effort.
I'll get it.
It's costing you money. That studio was in an even worse neighborhood than the one we just moved you out of. I worry about you, Mom.
Applesauce.
Mom, please.
Would you mind hanging on one second? Grace, telephone.
Hello?
Mrs. McQueen, I'm Julie Pollard of Kearney Stewart Raskoff Hulsey Advertising. I don't mean to disturb your dinner, but my agency likes your Story Lady program very much. We want to talk to you about doing one for a client of ours.
Oh, I don't think I could manage two programs. My daughter thinks I'm spending enough on the one.
Oh, no, Mrs. McQueen. We'd pay you to do it on network television.
Meg, would you come here, please? Dear, would you mind repeating that?
First, we'll film a pilot, Mrs. McQueen.
Oh, call me Grace, please.
Now, a pilot is a sample show, Grace. If the network likes it, we'll film 13 more. That's what they call a cycle.
Oh, like the dog food.
Oh, well, not quite.
Okay. If you turn here to page 18, paragraph 5A, you'll see we've been extremely generous for a performer with such limited experience.
Oh, I don't care about the money, but where I'm going to find the time to do both shows.
Wait a second. Didn't anyone explain to you? You're going to have to give up the cable show.
But I've just started Wind in the Willows. I can't leave Mr. Toad sitting in the middle of the road with his caravan in a ditch.
What I think has to happen...
That could be a problem with scheduling. We'll have to see how your time works out.
Mm-hmm. Well...
Did we leave something out?
I just want to see what sort of job you have for Scott.
Who?
My executive producer. He's the one who made the show what it is. I just showed up.
We'll be taking care of all those decisions, Grace.
Oh, no. No, I can't work without my regular producer. We're a team.
I'm on you, Felix. Hit it! Yeah, here we come.
Bust the move! Head to the west side!
Hello?
Bust the move!
This is who?
No, someone wanna fight me. You wanna fight me?
A job where?
Bust the crowd. Speak on. Direct. Shift third.
Look, if this is some kind of joke.
Yes! Network, here I come!
And if Deanna gets nervous because I'm not here, just let her fly around the room for a few minutes. That always makes her feel better. And my maidenhair fern...
gets misted every morning except on days without much sun.
Now, did I put in my eye drops?
I don't think you'll be needing them for a while.
Why ever not?
Your eyes have their old sparkle back. I was beginning to wonder if I'd ever see it again.
What nonsense. All I'm going to do is read a few stories. What's the big deal?
Come on, we'll be late. Star.
Oh, hello,
Grace. Julie Pollard, this is my daughter, Meg Denton.
How do you do?
So nice to meet you at last.
It's a pleasure. Come on in.
I hope you didn't have too much trouble finding the place.
Oh, I know the streets down here can be pretty tricky.
Oh, I love this part of Manhattan. One of the few areas where you can get this wonderful light. Oh, what a lovely apartment.
Are you sure putting me up is no trouble? New Jersey isn't such a long trip.
Oh, we want to make this week as easy as possible for you. I hope you don't mind us borrowing your mother for a while.
Well, I know we won't eat as well while she's away.
I have to tell you, my daughter is your number one fan. She wouldn't hear of you staying anywhere else. Alex? Alex?
It's the Story Lady.
Alexandra, your Story Lady has a name. It's Mrs. McQueen.
Hello, Alex. I understand I have you to thank for all this.
Can't believe it's really you.
I was so tickled when your mother suggested this. It gives us all a chance to get to be really good friends.
Well, she also didn't want to take any chances of something happening to you. She thinks the Nielsens are going to go crazy over you.
Oh. Well, I can't wait to meet them. Ready? These are some of the books I brought to read on the show.
Oh, how nice. And you know the toy company will have a few suggestions as well.
Oh, we can talk about that later. Let's get going. We have a very busy week ahead of us.
Bye.
Hello, boys and girls. I'm Granny Goodheart, and this is my enchanted cotton.
No. You're not twinkling enough. What did I say? Twinkle, twinkle, TV star, pour it on and you'll go far.
I don't understand. Why can't I just act natural?
Mrs. McQueen, this is television. There's no place for acting natural. On the top. And remember, I want non-stop twinkle.
Hello, boys and girls. I'm Granny Goodheart. And this is my enchanted cottage.
That's it.
What a day. Costume fittings, makeup tests, coaching.
It must all seem a bit dizzying at first, Grace, but soon you'll take it all in stride. Alex, how is school today?
Oh, Mother, I have to tell you.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. Sweetie, will you two please excuse me?
Your poor mother. Doesn't she ever have a moment when she's not on the job?
She wants to be head of programming in 3 years. We discussed our long-range plans a lot.
Well, that's nice.
It's very important. Who knows what the ball game will be like when I'm out of school?
What ball game?
Everybody's got to have an MBA now. I might have to go to law school on top of it.
Don't children get to play and romp and dream anymore?
Not if they want into the Ivy League.
I'm sorry. There are problems where they're building the set. Can you two get home all right?
Mother, it's only 4 blocks.
I've taken care of the bill. I'm sorry, sweetheart. Good night, Grace.
Your mother tells me you're going to be in a Christmas pageant. Playing a ghost.
But the nice one. The ghost of Christmas yet to be.
Isn't he the one who tells Scrooge about all the wonderful things he's been missing? I always like that part of the story. May I come and see you in it?
Oh, I love it. It's on the 21st.
I won't forget. Will I get to meet your father that night?
I doubt it.
What? What kind of father doesn't go to his daughter's play?
The kind that lives in San Francisco. He's a venture capitalist.
I gather they're,
divorced. I have only 2 friends whose parents aren't.
Oh, Alex, I am sorry to hear that.
Oh, it's okay. He's nice, and he comes to New York a lot. And he and Mommy send each other very friendly faxes.
My Grandma Fitzgerald lived in a house like this. And she wore dresses like that one. Only her bustle was built in.
It's very nice.
Don't tell me children don't ask Santa Claus for toys anymore. Well, what do they ask for?
The kind I have is for first graders, but that one right there, that's the kind you have to know to be accepted into Yale pre-prep.
What's that?
Oh, well, it's a summer program. Mom and Daddy met at Yale. If I'm not accepted, it'd break their hearts.
Alex, it's nearly 10.
I couldn't sleep.
And why not?
I saw this on your dresser.
Well, this looks more interesting than what I'm reading. The Snow Queen by Hans Christian Andersen. Now, we are about to begin, and you must attend. And when we get to the end of the story, you will know more than you do now about a very wicked hobgoblin. He was one of the worst kind. In fact, he was a real demon. One day, he was in a high state of delight because he had invented a mirror.
Morning.
What pretty curtains.
Let's hope the ghost of Christmas yet to be agrees with you. She'll be wearing them.
Oh, no. Let me give you a hand.
Oh, Grace, you don't have to, really.
Well, wait a minute now. That's not strong enough. You need a heavier thread. What's this now?
Oh,
this
I
should
see.
Work, I think, better than what you've got.
Believe me, I'm no seamstress.
You're doing very well. Looks very pretty.
What are you doing?
Now, you knot it a couple of times, like that.
Oh.
There.
Thank you.
Alex tells me you and her father met at Yale.
He was in the MBA program, and I wanted to be a playwright. It was back in the days when dreams still seemed like possibilities.
I can't imagine going through life without some kind of dream. Do you think that you and he will ever get back together?
I doubt it. He says he has to have his own space. So now he's got California.
I'm glad I lived when I did. Back then, needing more space meant you built bookshelves or bought a sofa bed. Alex seems to have taken it very well. Is she always so composed?
I don't know where she gets it. Certainly not from anybody I know. Sometimes I wonder if she'd be better off in boarding school. She'd probably have more stability in her life.
You know, you don't get these years back. Today you're making a ghost costume. Tomorrow you'll be helping her into a wedding dress. It goes by that quickly, believe me.
Shall we have a go at it, then? Great, Granny. And action. No, no!
No, no, I'm sorry. Look, darling, you walk right through the wall, though. You've got to come over here. To the window here, yeah? And from the window to the door here, and then down to the garden gate, where the little kiddies will be waiting, I know it's a bit difficult, but the actual set won't be ready until taping day. Have another go at it, then. Yeah. So, how's the run-through going?
Otis, I'm worried about this promotional tour for Granny Goodhart.
That was my idea.
Don't you think 10 cities in 2 weeks is too much for Grace?
Julie, she's our employee, not our mother.
A tour like this is rough. I'm worried about her.
Upgraded to first class in all the planes.
Thank you.
Why is everybody so quiet?
Tomorrow's taping day, sweetheart. How is dress rehearsal, Grace?
Oh, a breeze. How was your day?
The usual. Nothing worth mentioning. You're going to be just fine tomorrow, Grace.
Listen, Julie. If I'm not and you want to get somebody else, I won't mind.
Where would I ever find someone like you?
I'm not so special.
We think you are. Don't we, Mother?
Oh, yes.
To the show.
To the show.
To the show.
Came up 2 yards short on the
day. Delivery.
The sets look fabulous.
Said they want her to over.
Beautiful.
Back, hot point.
Right, camera three, you push in, please. Have you got that new cue sheet?
Nobody told me about it.
Julie, we're already a half hour behind.
Right, now can you frame up a bit? Yeah.
We have 2 minutes to taping. Everyone clear the set. Camera's in first position. Okay, let's get Snowflake behind the window, please.
We have makeup.
Otis, what's going on?
Okay. Ooh, gotta go.
There she is now. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting Granny Goodheart.
Sandbox toy said she should match the doll. I love it!
Welcome to my enchanted cottage.
Grace, is that you in there?
Right, places, everyone. Places, please. Script, please.
No, not that one. This one.
Granny, you look super. Scott, would you take her on a set, please?
Yes, Grace.
Could I have some light, please? Thank you.
Scott. Do I look as ridiculous as I feel?
Grace, you're gonna do great. Hey, they haven't touched the most important part. What's in here?
Thank you, Scott.
Okay, can I hear it once? Granny, Granny, you're back there?
Yes.
Okay, now, Granny, when we hear Snowflake say...
Wow! Hey, Granny, I think I hear the children coming up the hill.
And?
I go to the door. I come out. I go to the gate.
Granny, can we get a bit more spring in your step?
It's these boots. I asked for size 8. These seem like 6.5.
We can't have that squeaking. Buzz, does the mic pick up the shoes?
Yeah, but I can fix it.
All right, great. Granny, take your seat. And the kiddies from the village all come in and take their places. Great. Hurry up now. Yeah, mate, you come right up here. That's great. All right. All right. Now, you take your storybook. It's a bit different from the one that was in the rehearsal.
Oh, I'm so glad. That was just one long commercial. For some wonderful products.
Great. Well, kids, shall we try and do one? Eh? All right. Here we go now.
Stand by, everybody. Here we go.
And whenever he got sad, all he had to do was think about playing with the butterflies, and all was well. The end.
Right.
Okay, darling. Once more, scene one. From the top.
All right, lunch for 1 hour. Sorry, union rules.
Saved by the bell. Julie?
Grace. Oh, Julie. I'm so sorry. I've never felt so clumsy and tongue-tied in my life.
Oh, you're doing absolutely fine, Grace. No one could ask for more than you're giving us, and we're simply delighted. Now, we'll have Scott bring you some lunch and a nice cup of tea and just relax. We've got all the time in the world. Otis.
What are you smiling about?
Otis, the client, is here. Do we want them to think we don't have everything under control?
I see.
Yes.
So what the heck are we going to do now?
You're taking the client out for a liquid lunch. I need time to think.
Oh, you just do that. And you think about your next job if we lose this account, okay?
Oh, Alex. I'm not doing very well, am I? Everybody must be so mad at me.
No, no. You should have seen the show Mommy did called Pets on Parade. When they got nervous, it took an hour to clean up.
Oh. Is the hour up already?
I think I figured out what's wrong. Stand up. Come here, Grace. Turn around. Lift up your skirt. Yep. Off with this. Right. Have a seat. Come on. Sit down. Take off your glasses. Now. Let's go. Have a seat, Grace.
Well, where is everybody?
I've sent home all the visitors and given the crew an extra hour for lunch. Make yourself comfortable. Alex, sit right here. Oh. Now, you're going to do what you do better than anyone else in the world. Tell a story.
But who's going to take it?
Your old crew.
Ready when you are, story lady.
Please, God, let this work.
Wish me luck.
Once upon a time, there was a little boy who didn't like school very much. There were so many more interesting things to do, like chasing butterflies or watching clouds, or wondering why some bugs had 100 legs when 2 suited him just 5. Sometimes he felt as if the clouds and birds and butterflies were trying to tell him something, some special secret only they knew. And whenever he got sad, all he had to do was think of playing with the butterflies, and all was well. The end.
That was perfect!
Yeah!
Well, maybe this isn't going to be so bad after all.
That was great.
All you have to do is send everyone home.
That was just this once, Grace. When the show is picked up, we'll have to have all those people here.
We will?
Oh. I wouldn't worry about it for now. Another month of coaching with Rita and you won't even know the crew is there. But you must concentrate, Grace. You don't want to let us down, do you? Grace, you know, you're more than welcome to stay with us through the weekend.
Oh, no, I've imposed too much on you already. You've treated me like a queen.
Oh, well, we've loved having you. Haven't we, sweetie?
Mm-hmm. Oh,
that'll be Meg.
I'm going to miss you, Grace.
Oh, and I'm going to miss you, too. We had so much fun, didn't we?
Yeah.
And I learned so much from you. Although I'm sorry my poor old brain never did get the hang of Donkey Kong. Now, Alexandra, I wasn't that bad, was I? I was hoping to see that beautiful smile of yours once more.
I was hoping for one more story.
Well, we'll just have to get together again, won't we?
When?
Well, I'm coming into town for your play. I wouldn't dream of missing it.
Do we have to wait that long?
No, of course not.
Let me get my date book.
Why don't we do this? Why don't I forget this one? And then you can find it in a day or two. And then I'll just have to come back and get it, won't I? Now, Alex, what's our favorite part of the story?
To be continued.
Because there's always so much more to look forward to, isn't there?
Well, I hope real life won't seem dull now after your taste of the bright lights.
Oh, it won't, believe me.
Thank you so much for everything, Julie. Mm. You've given my mother an experience she'll never forget.
Oh, somehow in all the excitement yesterday, I forgot to give you this.
What is it?
Your paycheck for the show. Let's hope there are many, many more.
Indeed.
We'll probably know in a few days.
Ready, Mom?
Julie? I don't quite know how to thank you.
I don't either.
So today was payday. Shall we go straight to the bank?
No, I want to go home. Oh, wait. There's something I want to do.
You will see that this is delivered just before Christmas.
Of course. Now, will this be cash?
Oh, dear. I'm afraid I only have this check.
Madam, I'm afraid the store doesn't cash check. But I'm sure you'll have no trouble getting a charge account approved.
Hello?
Grace? Julie Pollard.
Julie! I haven't heard from you in a couple of weeks. I was beginning to wonder if you'd changed your mind about the show.
No, not at all. As a matter of fact, I'm calling to tell you that Sandbox Toys is thrilled with the pilot. They've given us the go-ahead for a double batch, 26 episodes. Grace? Are you there?
I'm speechless. With pleasure. Congratulations, Julie. You've worked so hard on this.
Well, I'm afraid the work is just beginning. We'll be going into production in about a month. And there's one small detail, Grace, we'd like attended to before we start taping. We've made an appointment for you with a Dr. Irvine.
A doctor? Whatever for?
Oh, no, it's nothing at all important. We'd just like his opinion on something. Do you have a pencil?
Mm-hmm. Good, solid bone.
Too bad about that malocclusion.
Rules out bonding.
Mm. Nothing seriously amiss here, Mrs. McQueen. You have taken care of your teeth.
Good. Well, if that will be all.
Mrs. McQueen, you weren't sent here for checkup.
I wasn't?
No. No, you were sent here for a brand new smile. My favorite happens to be the dazzle. But a lot of older women request the Rhapsody in White. As you can see, dentures have come a long way since we've improved the whitening process.
False teeth.
No, Mrs. McQueen, nobody's called them that for ages. And capping is not really a viable alternative considering your age and the time it takes.
Dr. Irvine, my teeth and I go back a long, long way. We're very attached to each other. And we're going to remain that way.
Hey, Mrs. McQueen, you're probably going to need dentures eventually. Why not let somebody else pay for the very best you can get?
Because the good Lord put these teeth in here, and he's the only one who's going to decide when they're coming out. I'm sorry to have wasted your time.
Grace, now, calm down.
I will not calm down. I'm not letting some stranger loose in my mouth with a pair of pliers.
Grace, I'm sorry we didn't go over this before. Now, can we talk about this later? Now, you are coming into the city tonight for Alex's play, aren't you?
Of course. I wouldn't dream of missing it.
Then, Grace, please stay with us and we can discuss this in the morning with Mr. Raskoff. I'm sure we can work something out. Wonderful. I'll see you at the apartment at 5:30. Bye. Is the board of directors here?
They just called from the plane. They're in a two-hour holding pattern. Meeting's been moved from 11 to 2:30.
What about my daughter's play?
Dinner's been ordered.
Phase one, I want network and cable ad placement raised 20%. And I want a 25% increase in local radio spots effective tomorrow. Everybody will be running from mall to mall in their station wagons, and this is the only way we can nail the parents.
Oh, come on, Alex. I'm sure your mother's already at the school. Oh, I'm sorry. I don't know where my mind is. She said we were to meet her there.
You have reached the Pollard residence. Please leave.
Julie, we're waiting.
I'm sorry. I've got to call my daughter's school. Otis, will you please take over my part of the presentation?
Come on, Julie. Those studies were your idea. You know how I feel about taking credit for other people's work?
Or the blame.
We're gonna be great. Now, come on, let's hurry.
You're just about to leave. Oh, wonderful. We're on the 7th row on the aisle.
Wonderful.
Goodbye.
Grace?
Oh, Alex, is that you? Oh, you scared me half to death. Oh, my poor heart.
Were you able to reach Mommy?
She's just about to jump into a cab. She'll be here any minute.
Okay, great. Well, you better go sit down because we're going to start. Bye.
Please.
Excuse me.
We have interviewed all the leading child development consultants regarding program content, and they find that good programming can help fill all the emotional voids that the child may experience. Now, our September survey indicates...
No, Ebenezer, I'm not a bad dreamer, a figment of your imagination. I'm the ghost of Christmas past, and I've been sent to help you see the errors of your selfish life. There's nothing to be afraid of. We are going to be taking a magical journey back in time, back to your boyhood, to see people and places you loved. Come with me, Ebenezer. Take my hand, and we shall fly to the land of happy memories you've long forgotten.
Julie! A wonderful presentation. Can you join us for a little Christmas cheer?
I'm sorry, sir. I'm late for my daughter's school pageant. Excuse me. Oh!
Yes, Ebenezer, but with all those possessions and wealth in the world, that could never take the place of love or the people around us. For our greatest treasure is the moments we have together and the kindnesses that we give to one another, for they are rarer than jewels, more precious than gold. For without people that love us, near to us, Christmas is indeed just another day. For Christmas is a time for joyous togetherness, friends and family, sharing in spirit of peace on earth, goodwill to men.
Hey lady, did you just see the sign?
I can't change the 20.
Really, really proud
of you. Is anybody here? Mrs. Oberg.
Yes?
Julie Pollard, Alexandra's mother.
Oh, yes, of course. It's nice to see you again.
I guess I'm a little late.
You missed the whole show? Alex was wonderful.
How upset was she?
Oh, she's a very grown-up little girl. I'm sure she understands.
Well, I guess I'd better be getting home. Nice to see you.
Good night, Mrs. Pollard. Merry Christmas.
And you remembered all those lines so beautifully. I could never have done so well.
Thank you.
Does your school do a play at Easter?
Yeah.
Well, you'll be sure and let me know when it is. I'll be there.
That'd be nice.
Your mother told me so many times how much she looked forward to tonight, Alex. Something must have gone terribly wrong at work. Maybe Granny Goodheart's cottage burned down.
I'm sure there's a good reason. There always is.
You should have seen how hard she worked on your costume, Alex. She was so serious, you just knew that making that costume just right and seeing her little girl in it was the most important thing in the world to her. Julie. Oh, we were worried. Well, maybe I should leave you two alone.
Alex, I'm so very, very sorry. I tried so hard to make it, there was nothing that could be done. Alex, you and I have talked about this. As badly as I want to be with you, sometimes I simply can't. Is there anything I can do? Radio City. Oh, I can get you that button. Alex.
It meant a lot to me, too, Alex. Honestly, I had it in my calendar. And
gee, I must be really important.
You know what my life is like. I thought we had an understanding.
No. What we have are appointments.
Alex!
Mrs. Oberg said you were absolutely wonderful. She said she had tears in her eyes during your speech at the end.
I did too.
Alex.
This wasn't the first time.
I know. And I wish I could say it'll never happen again.
Mommy, how could you? This meant so much to me. I worked so hard.
I know that, sweetheart.
And you weren't there. I was the only one there tonight that didn't have a parent.
Believe me, I tried.
No, you didn't. You don't care.
Alex, you know that's not true. It was absolutely impossible. Now, how many times have we talked about this since Daddy left?
Every time something matters to me.
It's so difficult being the only parent here. You have to do things you hate, and you wind up hurting the very person that means more to you than anything.
And who's that? Which client?
Alex, I'm sorry. That's all I can say. Oh, Grace. I feel so terrible. Everything I do seems wrong.
Oh, Julie.
I get pulled away by so many things. I can't remember a time when I wasn't doing one thing, scheduling another, thinking of three other things all at once, none of them about my daughter. I just wish there were more hours to the day.
Well, until that happens, I think you're going to have to learn to say no once in a while. I've been remembering something I haven't thought of for years. Did I ever tell you that I did a bit of singing when I was younger?
No.
Nothing spectacular, just with a few bands around the neighborhood. But I wasn't half bad. I had a chance to go on a USO tour that was going to end up in California. And the band leader said he knew a lot of radio and movie people he could introduce me to. Well, what an opportunity. Well, Meg's father and I were pretty serious. And oh, the sleepless nights I had, weeks of them. Should I go? In the end, I decided not to. And you know, Julie, I can't even remember that band leader's name now.
Is it true when people get older, you almost never hear anybody wish they'd spent more time on their work?
You hear every other complaint, but never that.
Did Mr. Metzger tape the pageant? He usually does. I'll call him tomorrow and see if he can lend me the tape. We can watch it together.
I'm gonna be late. Will you be home for dinner?
As far as I know.
How did it go?
Modified silent treatment. Can't say I blame her.
Julie, I've been thinking...
Yes, perhaps... Grace. I'm sure you have. Shall we go? Otis said he could squeeze us in at 9.
I've been a real good sport about everything, haven't I?
Oh, yes, Grace.
That funny outfit. Having to tell stories I don't feel good about. I haven't said a word.
You've been the very soul of cooperation, Miss McQueen. Real trooper.
Well, this trooper doesn't see what her teeth have to do with anything.
Mrs. McQueen, this is your contract with us. And if you turn to page 73, section 8, paragraph 3, clause H, you see, undersigned agrees to submit to any and all changes in her personal appearance deemed necessary by the client and or agency.
Haven't you done enough to me? The time you got through with me, even my own daughter didn't recognize me.
Nevertheless, Mrs. McQueen, you signed a contract that gives us the right to do this.
And if I refuse?
Oh, I wouldn't do that if I were you. Breach of contract suits can be very long and very expensive. So, 10 a.m. Monday, Dr. Irvine's office.
Well...
I'm sure there's a very simple way out of this.
Just in case, though, we know a really good lawyer. I mean, these agency guys have everything pretty well covered in here. Right down to the morals clause.
The what?
The morals clause? Here, listen to this. Should the undersigned be involved in any crime, immoral act, or engage in any activity deemed unsuitable to the image of Granny Goodhart, blah, 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 this contract shall thenceforth be declared null and void.
Let me see that.
Imagine putting something like that in a contract with Mom.
Well, first thing in the morning, I'll call Sid. I'm sure he'll be in the office even on Christmas Eve.
Mom? Mom?
Shoplifter on 1J.
I've seen her somewhere.
One of our regulars?
No, that's not it. I don't believe it. That's the story lady.
The what?
The story lady. This TV show my little girl used to watch.
Code 6, ground floor, jewelry. Older woman, camel hair coat. Remember, she's got to leave the building with the goods.
Okay. I'm on her.
It's $125 an ounce.
Oh, my. Don't you have anything a little less heavenly?
Now, this one is called... What happened to the Shalimar?
Search me.
Wait a minute there, Grandma.
There you are. What took you so long?
What
Right here. You can't do this to Granny Goodheart. I have a doll named after me. Maybe my own cereal someday.
It's the old lady.
They're putting my name on lunchboxes in Taiwan, even as we speak.
Bellevue missing somebody?
It's no joke, Sergeant. This lady has a kids' TV show.
Oh. Get the camera over here. Come on.
Oh, please. This mustn't get out. How would it look if the world finds out that Granny Goodheart was arrested on Christmas Eve? Hello? What? She what? I'll be right there. Oh, please. This mustn't get out. What will happen if the world finds out that Granny Goodheart is arrested on Christmas Eve? Oh.
Mrs. McQueen, a senior citizen plucked from obscurity.
There must be some mistake.
Just announced children's television.
I just don't believe this. We've got to do something.
PR is issuing a statement that we decided to recast the part a week ago. Casting's been...
Otis, noticed. That's not what I meant. What are we going to do to help Grace? What?
That's it, Julie, nothing. And neither are you. Now, that's in order. Look, she's a sweet old lady. We're all very fond of her. But you know the children's market better than that. We can't risk associating this project with the kleptomaniac.
Oh, for goodness sake,
this
lady is...
Thank you, Cindy. Casting sent down tape on every actress over 50 on both coasts. Now, have your choices ready right after the holidays. Julie, I'm sorry, but that's the way it is. Merry Christmas.
Sure.
Addressed to me. Oh, Winston, I'm so glad you joined us.
Yeah.
Oh, Alex.
Hi, Alex.
Meg?
Oh, Julie.
Hi.
This is my husband, Norman.
How do you
nice
do?
You.
How do you do? Hi, I'm Alex.
Hi.
This is our lawyer friend, Winston Kennedy.
Oh, well, this is our lawyer friend. See, hello, oh. Please, Major.
Scott!
Well, you think I'd let Grace rot in jail on Christmas Eve? Oh. This is my ex-roommate and paralegal.
We seem well represented. Who goes first?
First, I think we should find Grace.
Good idea.
Of course.
Excuse me, sir. We're looking for Mrs. Grace McQueen.
She's my mother.
Well, you guys are a little late, aren't you? The lady's been in judge's chambers for the past 10 minutes.
Without counsel?
And after all of that, Your Honor, it wasn't enough that they took the heart and soul out. They wanted my teeth, too. And this was the quickest way I could think of to get out of this mess. You're looking at me as if you don't believe a word of all this. And I don't blame you.
Not at all. I'm looking at you like this for breaking my youngest granddaughter's heart, leaving her hanging in the middle of the wind in the willows.
But that was their doing, too. Oh, please, Your Honor, tell her I'm sorry I disappointed her.
Not as disappointed as she was when I tried to finish the story. Mrs. McQueen, you have no idea of the meaning of the word defeat until you've looked into the eyes of a 6-year-old child and realized you're not making it as a toad. Well, my daughter-in-law said you used a voice.
I did? Oh, heavens, no. I was just trying to be toady, you know, puffed up and excitable. Oh, toad is very excitable. But look here. Surely you don't expect Mr. Toad of Toad Hall to traipse around the countryside dressed as a washerwoman? You can do it. Try.
What? You expect Mr. Toad of Toad Hall?
That's good, but give it more bluster.
What? You expect Mr. Toad of Toad Hall to traipse around the countryside dressed as a washerwoman?
The motor car went poop, poop, poop as it raced along the road.
Who was it steered it into a pond?
Ingenious Mr. Toad!
That's it! Now you practice it every morning while you're shaving.
Well, that solves my problem, Mrs. McQueen. Now, what are we going to do about yours?
Everything will be all right, sweetheart. I won't let anything happen to Grace. Mothers think they have all the answers, Alex. We're supposed to, anyway. I know it doesn't always seem like it. But you're the most important thing in the world to me. I love you.
I know, Mommy. I'm sorry I threw things. It won't happen again either. I love you, Mommy.
You think you'll be able to fit me into your busy schedule?
Oh, I'll have to check my book when I get home. I think so.
What is she doing?
Grace. Is everything okay?
So what did the judge say, Mom?
Oh, he's such a nice man. He has 11 grandchildren, imagine
about
that.
About the charges, Grace.
Well...
Everyone rise for the judge!
I guess we'll find out now.
That dumb show, I wish I'd never thought of it.
Oh, don't say that. I should have had enough sense to say on cable TV, where I belong. Oh, that was so much fun. I felt involved. I got to do something I loved. And people responded in so many wonderful ways. I'll never forget that.
Well, a defendant stepped forward.
Even if I'm on bread and water for the rest of my days.
Having given the age and circumstances of the defendant a great deal of thought, it is the opinion of the court that the defendant is beyond rehabilitation by conventional methods. Therefore, I sentence the defendant to 2 years. Community service. To begin at noon on Monday at the first address on this list. Don't be late.
Oh, Your Honor.
And Merry Christmas.
From each egg came a little duckling that lifted its head and cried, peep, peep. Quack, quack, said the mother. And then all the ducklings quacked as well as they could. The little ducklings looked all around. They were delighted with what they saw, especially the big green leaves. How large the world, they said, when they found out how much more room they had now than when they were inside their eggshells.
What I've always wanted to do, jump on the bed.
No, get down. Dear.
Over we go.
No, you're supposed to take the stairs. You're not supposed to jump.
What's Sally doing upstairs?
You can hurt yourself.
What's she doing? Let's go check her out.
Oh, now we'll never get her down.
And so, a new year dawned,
and the lady found herself banished to a little chair off in a corner of a great big room. But she's not at all sad, and not in the least bit lonely. For you see, except for the toy company, whose recast version of Granny Goodheart was clobbered in the ratings and got stuck with 2 million unsold lunchboxes, everybody lived happily ever after.